Hello, welcome to Lab 200 of VMware SalesPlay, exporting the snapshot of application virtual machine. In this lab, we'll build an on-prem virtual machine by using an Ubuntu base image, install the OS Commerce application on top of it, export into the OVF format, which is the right format to be imported into OCVS, our Oracle Cloud VMware service. Now, this is an optional lab. Should you wish to skip this part, you can directly download the pre-built VMDK image by clicking the link here. Okay, so let's get started with the lab. Now to work on this lab, you will need a VMware software, VMware Workstation if you are using Windows machine, or VMware Fusion if you are using macOS. Download the software and install in your machine. Next, you would need to download this Ubuntu base image so that you can import this and start building your application on top of it. Now I already have both of these things set up on my machine, so I'll move on to the next step. Okay, so now open up your VMware software. Since I'm on Windows machine, I'm opening VMware Workstation. If you're using macOS, again, you would have VMware Fusion. In this, we will import the base Ubuntu image. Now I already have the Ubuntu base image downloaded. Go ahead and unzip this folder. Okay, once it's unzipped, move back to your VMware Workstation application and click Open a Virtual Machine. Here we will import the base image that we just unzipped. It pre-populates all the configuration and the names that you have given. So click Import. And then click Power on the Virtual Machine. We will wait for our VMware machine to boot up. Okay, our Ubuntu machine is now available. We have named the Ubuntu machine OS Commerce and the password is also OS Commerce. Enter the password and log in into the VM. Okay, once I am within my VM, click Don't Upgrade. Okay. And I'll quickly check if I have internet access within the virtual machine. So open up your browser and visit any website to see if you have internet connection. Okay, so I do have internet access within my virtual machine. Now what I'm gonna do is the first time when you boot your machine, it actually starts a lot of upgrades in the backend. And I do not want to do that because when you run some scripts, you run into errors if there are some backend processes that is upgrading your OS. So what you can do is quickly give a restart to your machine and that should solve your problem. So I'll quickly come here and say restart guest OS. Click restart. Okay, enter your password to log back in. Awesome. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open the lab document in this machine so that I don't have to, type all the commands that will be needed to configure your application. You can simply copy and paste your commands in the terminal. So open up your browser and copy the lab link that you have. Okay, perfect. So we have the lab document available here now. Also on the side, open up your terminal so that you can type your commands there. Okay, so what we are gonna do is on this Ubuntu image, we are gonna install LampStack and then we'll install our OS Commerce on top of it, okay? So the very first step is to install MySQL file. So copy the command and paste it into your terminal. When it prompts for your password, remember your password to the base image is OS Commerce. Say yes. Here it will prompt you for a new password for your MySQL database that it will set up. I am gonna enter OS Commerce so that I remember my passwords. It's usually OS Commerce. Repeat the same password and confirm. Okay. So it starts configuring your packages now. Okay. Next, we'll do the MySQL installation. The enter password that you had used for your database. So I have used OS commas. Say no. Change password, no. Remove anonymous users, yes. Disallow root login remotely, yes. Remove test database and access to it, yes. Reload privileged tables now, yes. All done. Now the values to the prompt are also given in your lab document. Okay, the next step is to now install Apache Server. Once you have this installed, you can confirm that you have the Apache Server up and running by typing localhost in your browser. It will show you the default Apache homepage. Okay, so I have Apache Server configured correctly. Next, I'll go and install PHP 7. Now, if this command does not work for you, type the next command that's available. But assuming that we all use the same base image, I think it will work for all of us. Okay, I'll now restart my Apache server. And done. Next, now let's log in into the MySQL database and then configure our database and the user that is needed to log into it. Enter the password for your database. In my case, it's OS commas. Now, I would recommend copying and pasting all these commands so that it is so that you do not have any errors while typing them out. We create a database called as OS commas. Next, we create a user called as OS commas user. We give all the permissions that are needed, so we grant all those permissions and then we flush privileges. Alright, now to exit out of MySQL, simply type exit. Enter. Next, what we'll do is we'll configure the SSH server. So copy this command. Next, we'll install IP table persistent. Now, say yes to both these prompts. Next, add the two rules for allowing the port 22 and 80. Within your IP tables. And then save the configuration. And reload. Done. So we have all the packages that are needed now for your OS commas installation. So let's make a temporary directory and Let's make a temporary directory and download the OSCommerce files here. Unzip. And what we'll do is we'll copy the OSCommerce files into the var.www.html folder. Next, we'll modify the permission so that our Apache server can use these files. Right now, since we have downloaded with the root user, the owner of those files is root. So we'll modify the permissions and make Apache the owner to it. Okay, so you have all the files that are needed now. Next, what we'll do is in your browser, go to localhost/catalog. Let me close my terminal as I'm done with it. Okay, click start. Now provide the username that you have created for your database server, that in our scenario, it is root. Give the password for your database user. I have kept it as OSCommerce. And the name of the database is again OSCommerce. It says the database structure is now imported. Okay, database imported successfully. Now leave this as default and click continue. Now get creative with this, you know, enter your own store name. Store name, my store. Owner name, say OSCommerceAdmin. Email ID, OSCommerceAdmin@mystore.com. Admin username, I'll keep it as OSCommerceAdmin. Password, I'll keep it as OSCommerce. Now, while I'm in the New York time zone, so I'll update that. Doesn't really matter. Click continue. Okay, so our installation and configuration is done. Okay, so now let's log in as an admin user. So click administrative tool. Enter the username and password that you entered in your last screen. So OSCommerceAdmin and password was OSCommerce. And click login. Okay, we are within our admin console for the application. Here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a product to my catalog. Okay, so go to this left menu, click catalog, go to manufacturers, and here we will add Oracle as a manufacturer. Okay, so click insert, manufacturer name Oracle, and for an image, what I'm gonna do is I'll quickly download an Oracle logo. I'll pick this first logo and save it to my machine. Okay, come back here and provide the path to that image that you just downloaded. And then click save. You'll see Oracle is now added as a manufacturer. Okay, next go to categories product. Within this, go to hardware. And here what we'll do is we'll create a new category called as Oracle again. So category name Oracle, and for the image I'm going to use the same image that I just downloaded. Okay, click save. Okay, so now I have the Oracle category. Within this category I will add a new product now. So click new product and again get creative with this. Product manufacturer in our scenario is now Oracle. Product name, let's see, I am going to add Exadata. Price, say $2,500, $2,081. And for image, again, I'll quickly go and download a Exadata image. Save the first image. Okay, I have the image downloaded, so I'm gonna browse to that file and then click save. Okay, we can see Exadata has been added here. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll go to the website that our customers will see, localhost/catalog/index.php. This path is available in the lab document, so you copy and paste that. And this should take you to the store website. And here you can see that your Exadata product that you just added is now available for $2,500. All right, so this finishes the configuration for your virtual machine, on-prem virtual machine. So we have this machine, and now we want to import that into OCVS. So for that, we will have to export into an OVF format. So let's do that. So shut down this guest OS. All right, and then on this virtual machine, go to File and click Export to OVF. It will say what name do you want to use for your file. I will say OS Commerce. Okay, and then click Save. I will save it on desktop. Now, since this is a big VM, it will take some time to export. Okay, our VM is now exported. So if you go to your desktop where you saved your export OVF file, you should be able to see your three files, OS Commerce Desk 1, which is a VMDK file, a OVF file, and an MF file. What we'll do is we'll quickly compress this and zip it. Again, since this is a large file, it will take some time to compress it. Awesome, my file is zipped. I will give it a suitable name and save it. Next, what we'll do is we'll log in into a cloud tenancy and we'll go to object storage and create a public bucket. Within this bucket, we'll upload this zipped file so that it can be used in our next lab, Lab 300, where we import this into the VMware environment. Okay, so log in into your cloud tenancy and from the navigation menu, go to object storage. Select the compartment where you want to create your bucket and click create bucket. Give it a name and leave all the other options as default. Click create bucket. Now get inside this bucket and edit the visibility, make it public. Now what we'll do is we'll upload our zipped file that we have for our exported virtual machine. So browse to your file and select that zipped file. Click upload. Now again, since this is a large file, it will take a while to upload it to the object storage. Okay, our file is uploaded. Now the last step is that we have to create a pre-authenticated request that we'll use in our next lab, Lab 300. So click the three dots and then click create pre-authenticated request. Select an expiration date, I'll leave it to default and then click create here. Now copy this link as it will be needed in the next lab, and also it does not show up again. So make sure you take a note of this. All right, so close this, and this brings you to the end of your lab 200. In this lab, to summarize, we created an on-prem VM where we used Ubuntu base image and we installed application on top of it. And later we exported this into the OVF format, uploaded to object storage, and then created a pre-authenticated request so that we can use that in the next lab 200.